All right. So, welcome everyone. We will pick up where we left off last time. So, when we left off last time, we were finally all venturing out as a group, traveling north, roughly along that pink line there that I drew on the map, headed towards the camp of Medina Linaricel. Who's the leader of sort of a conclave of druids up in the northwest of the Elf Territory, who had discovered another interesting set of tunnels, or perhaps interesting, we'll find out, going under Einongrim. Oh, I'm seeing your Discord's messed up. Are you okay there, Kyrian? Okay, I can't hear you.
I can hear him.
Oh, you can. Do I have him muted?
You sound fine.
Depends if you mute everyone.
I can't hear
on
him
the
through Discord.
Roll 20.
Oh.
I'm broadcasting through Roll 20 since I can't talk through.
Oh, yeah.
Gotcha. Okay.
I'll
All
just
right.
Leave him turned on like that, I guess.
Yep. So I went ahead and activated that. So.
I could also do Roll 20, though. I can only barely hear KC.
Oh, that's because my microphone isn't on in Roll 20. So I have my microphone active now in Roll 20. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can.
Okay.
There's echoing now, though.
Yeah, the rest of you just need to hover over my profile and mute me on Roll 20. And let me know if that fixes things. And I'll just keep talking for a bit until I hear you confirm whether it's okay. Are we okay?
For yourself.
Confirmation, okay.
Alright, cool. Okay, so, yeah, so we were headed up roughly that way. Incidentally, in the off time, I went ahead and you would know this because you had a map there, but you have wait, I did measure this. Oh yeah, there we go. You've got a journey of a bit over 170 miles in front of you, so might take you a little while. But let's see how this goes. Actually, no, wait a minute. No, it's actually over 200 miles. So when we left off last time, we had a solid day of travel, found sort of a little cluster of trees that camp was made in. And yeah, so it's like dusk right now. The camp is being set up. Does anyone want to do anything in particular before headed to bed?
Do we have our spells now?
Yeah, you have all level 2 stuff, which I think is like 2 spell slots for you.
So can I? I just popped it out. Can I? I picked alarm, didn't I?
Yes.
I don't know if I'm supposed to. Does that do anything?
Yep. So that just shows me that it shows everyone what the spell does. Okay. So that being said, you're currently in a clearing that's about maybe like a 40-foot square, something like that. I'm willing to fudge a little bit on the distance, but basically what we've got going on is you're in this little clearing, you're surrounded sort of in two arcs like this by trees with sort of a little lane going out to the path here on one side and another lane going, you know, just over off to somewhere you don't
want to go. We're still on the map.
Yeah, I know. Are you looking at the stream?
Cool.
Cheater.
No.
I was describing the terrain without revealing things, sir. So you will act without knowledge of what you saw on the stream. Right,
I forgot it was so boring.
Alright, so yeah, so basically with your alarm spell you could cover one entrance or the other. Or you could put it off to, like, one side of your camp.
I guess I'll guard. Can I guard? Is it the way we came in?
Yeah. All right, you can do that.
Put alarm on that.
Okay, so let me see here. I'm just going to do some bookkeeping real quick. So you'd probably put it up there. Okay. Okay. So yeah, so you do that. are you doing the audible alarm version or the mental ping version?
Right. Yeah. Yeah. The, I guess I should have read it a little more. I guess a mental alarm.
Okay. So you will be alerted. Oh, wait. Oh yeah. Okay. So you'll be alerted if anything goes through that area. Okay. Anything else from anyone?
I'm going to go to sleep because there's nothing that can go wrong here. We're perfectly fine in the forest.
Okay. Sounds good. Well, it's not the forest, really. You're just, like I said, it's a little cluster of trees that you sort of found for shelter, off the side of, not, you weren't really going through a road, but it's more sheltered than just the grass that you were going through. All right, so if there's nothing else, then watches for the night. Are you all just going to bed? Are you having people take turns sort of looking out for bad things? You'll all want to get at least 6 hours and change of sleep, you know, maybe like 7 hours at least of total sleeping time to not slowly get exhausted.
I can take the second watch.
You do have two elves in your party, by the way, as well, which gives you some advantages here.
All right, they need less rest.
I'm going to meditate before I go to sleep, and then I will just sleep. So I guess I will take first. Unknowingly.
Wait, I think... Don't elves just require 4 hours meditation? That's it?
Yeah, that's what... Well, yeah.
Okay, all right, gotcha. Okay, so let me see then. So probably then... Colleen will stay up for, you know... 2 to 3 hours watching, then she'll go meditate. Kane will get up for a little bit. We probably need one more person to handle the last part of the night.
Who's the other?
Elf is Stalker, or Halael, who seems to be gone. But he said he was going right to sleep, so actually he'd wake up at about the right time, so we'll just say it's him.
When the alarm was set...
That's funny. Huh?
When the alarm was set, did he, choose, like, what won't wake, set it off? Or did he just set it?
It just alerts you whenever a creature goes in the area, and,
But did he specify, like, squirrels and stuff won't set it off, or did he just leave it?
Yeah, I mean, do you have any particular desires here? I was assuming that it would be, like, probably not tiny forest creatures and not your party and anything else would be
right. Yeah. Okay. That's fine. But if it's yes, so you can, really are you asking preferred. So you can sneak around?
I was just wondering if like Stalker had actually said that when he said the spell or not.
Or Radiclus. Yeah. Fowler. Yep. No, he didn't. Oh, yeah. But basically Fallon, I will simply assume that that's generally what you want. When you put alarm up and instruct me if it's anything different than that.
But the
will do.
All right. Cool. So okay. And actually for purposes of tracking spell slots, I'm gonna say that like your long rest is gonna begin now. So you'll recover all that stuff starting now, basically. So you can just give yourself back that spell slot. Okay. So, yeah, let me think. So, Colleen, you stay up while the others sort of arrange. Are you putting up like a campfire, by the way, or are you just letting it be dark?
I would just let it be dark. I don't have any sort of skills to make a fire. I'd assume someone would light it or not getting one. Someone else would do it, right? That's the noble thing to think.
So is it cold?
I'm fine with my dark vision. Just chilly.
I can cast Firebolt for you if you'd like a fire. That's about the only way I'm going to get one going, though.
Colleen's not going to ask. If you guys don't want a fire, there won't be a fire.
Okay, so wait, are we building a fire or not? I just need like yes or no.
Yeah, let's build a fire.
Okay. Alright, cool. So yeah, a few of you gather together some wood. Alistair throws a firebolt at it until it catches, and and yeah, you got a nice little campfire going. Okay. So most of you go to sleep. Colleen is sort of, you know, staying up, watching out. And let me see here. Yeah, so Colleen, you watch around. It's kind of boring. The grass rustles. You hear maybe like a gopher or something scurry by, but nothing too remarkable. Actually, before I say that, make a perception check.
I was about to say, you're giving me the free pass here.
Yeah.
Nailed it.
Actually, screw it. You don't notice the squirrel. You notice nothing. There's probably wind, but you're not sure.
Sounds just about right for Colleen.
And then after a while, you sort of look around and you're like, well, nothing bad happened, so I suppose I did all right. You tap Kane, who gets up, and you go off and meditate. Kane, your turn. Perception check time.
All right. Perception check. I'm good at those. I'm mediocre at those.
Okay. Yeah. So, you know, you sit up a bit as well, and you... Again, you do notice, unlike Colleen, when... like a small nocturnal creature scurries by the camp. You hear rustle, rustle. But then you sort of drift away and start staring off into the darkness. And at this point...
Can I throw my dagger at it?
Make an attack roll.
Would it still be off of Dex?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, make an attack roll with your dagger. It's off of Dex, so just normal attack roll. But Okay, I was going to say it was at disadvantage, but that kind of doesn't matter here because it's completely dark. Okay, so you're like, I'm bored. Screw you, tiny nocturnal creature. And you wing your dagger
into the distance.
You hear, like, a little thunk somewhere, maybe like 40 feet generically in front of you, but you're not sure. You're down the dagger for the moment. And actually, at this point, Fowlin hears a tiny ping in his mind. And you stir awake. Something has tripped your alarm. You've got about 3 seconds to do something before I switch the map you guys are on.
Do I understand what it is? Like, do I understand that it was the dagger? Or are you just telling me in general? Sorry.
Well...
Or were you indicating that it was the dagger?
A dagger wouldn't trigger alarm. You would know.
Okay. I guess I just say, on your feet, boys.
Okay.
And grab my axe.
Okay, cool. So you're really chopping in and out, by the way. So I don't know if I'm stuck with your mic again.
Am I okay now, or is it still choppy?
That's better. Was okay.
Okay, sorry, I don't know what happened.
Now you're choppy again, so.
I'll work on it.
All right, cool. Yeah, so everybody hears Fallon say, on your feet, and he, you know, jumps up from where he was sleeping, starts gathering his things really quickly, and as you look around you... Yeah. All right. So I'm using a fun little feature of Roll20 called dynamic lighting.
Ooh.
So you should be able to see only parts of the map. Also, the Elvish folk have different sight radiuses than the rest of you. So suffice to say, the fire is casting some light. Otherwise, you'll be limited by how far you can see. So non-elves can see 15 feet basically away from you. The elves can see 60 feet. So, and the areas that are blacked out are where the trees are blocking your vision. If you go past and into that area, it should light up for you.
Just so you know, Casey, I can see everything that's here still.
Yeah, it's because there's a fire and it's casting light.
Okay. So that's more than 15 feet away. I'm just making sure.
Oh, right. So you should be able to see further in this direction than in this direction.
Yeah, just about.
Okay. So, yeah, I went ahead and gave you a somewhat generous fire radius of 40 feet.
Okay. So. Just making sure I can see what I'm supposed to.
Yep. Yeah, you can. By the way, incidentally, here's the Spidey that tripped your alarm spell. So, everyone can roll initiative.
Makes sense.
Make sure to select your token before rolling.
Remember
after
what that
Casey
means.
Pulls up the table.
Woo! 10! Right.
Sorry about that.
Remind me how to select my token?
Click on your click actual on token on the screen. And then click your initiative roll.
Okay.
And it should pop up in the turn order over there.
Working on it. Hold on.
Everyone's doing so much better than me at initiatives.
You weren't.
That's because you have no initiative.
Oh, you were the one on watch, too.
Oh, whoops.
Yeah, but I'm not the one that knew that there were spiders. I just heard Fallon say, everyone up. I was about to go walk and look for my knife, to be honest.
Until and trip the alarm yourself.
So, you know, I guess it worked out that they tripped the alarm before I went off by myself into the dark to look for my knife.
By the way, I'm using colored dots now to put enemies into initiative groups. That's how I'm going to be doing it. So, and actually, you know what? Let me go ahead and give you Johan as well. I'll just make him Johan bot, and he probably won't do anything that impressive. But I'll
Johan, wake up.
I'll attack.
Wake up.
For you. Let me see here. So he has zero initiative.
So he won't be swinging cane around.
No, probably not.
No cane weapons today.
Okay, so he's at a 9. All right. So, So Haleo, you hear Fowlin alert your group, and you jump up to your feet, and you see what you see. Incidentally, you look at these, and you know, actually, give me a nature check.
And then there it is.
Okay, so incidentally, and I'm only going to do this once, but you know that giant spiders come in two varieties. There's the more ferocious kind that stories get written about mostly. These look a little bit different. They're fuzzier. You think they might be giant wolf spiders, actually?
Yeah.
But that being said, what would you like to do?
So I can see, well, 5 spiders, right?
Sounds right.
I can see what I can see. So. I can defer my turn, can't I?
You can.
All right, then. I'll do that, because I don't really want to leave the safety of this circle we've got going.
Okay.
Are you going to hide behind somebody?
No. Just going to stand
ready. Just tell me when you're ready to take your turn. Otherwise, okay. I'll put you at the end. Okay. Alistair.
All right, I'm going to firebolt the one closest to me, which
okay.
would be this one.
Yep. Can you pop up the spell for me again?
Yep. Here's...
Okay.
So, and I have the attack.
Okay, yep, that hits. Roll damage.
Do I click it again to roll damage?
Yep. All right, so Alistair, you pop up from where you were sleeping, you fumble around for a moment, and finally grab your wand-like piece of wood, and you throw it out in front of you, and you all see a ball of flame just hurl from Alistair, strike squarely into the spider. It reels back a little bit and looks really pissed. And now it's Wolf Spider's turn. So this one, all right, I gotta remind myself exactly what these things do. Okay.
They all got their own initiative?
No, I divided them into three groups. So this one,
there are more of them than you.
Than we see.
Yeah.
Is gonna come charging here.
That's fair.
And it will attack Haleo.
Right. So,
I think a 21 hits. So
just about.
So you take 6 points of damage as the spider comes rushing towards you and sinks its fangs into your just above the knee, I'll say. Go ahead and make a constitution saving throw. Okay.
No, wait, but it doesn't matter.
You take 3 additional damage as the poison courses through your body. And this spider also sees a juicy Haleo. let's go ahead and
man down.
See what happens here.
Did Haleo just die?
There's a 8 point damage.
I don't like spiders.
I don't like spiders anyway, either.
Do you have hit points left at this point?
No. Not positive ones, at any rate.
Okay. So, actually, let me see here. How does this actually work? You know what? I'm not exactly how this works, so go ahead and make another con save as you clutch to the last bit of his... Okay. And the poison of the second spider also courses through your body. And not only are you down, but you are also in really bad shape. Even if you got up. What I mean by that is you will be poisoned for the next hour. All right. Fallon, it's your turn.
Okay, so I can see those two spiders, so I guess I'm going to use my crossbow on, I guess that one, since it's the next closest to somebody else.
Okay, yeah, and Haleo's in a crumpled heap, so you have a clear shot.
I was going to yell duck, but I guess I don't need to. So I guess I need to roll that.
Okay, so you aim your crossbow at it, but you know what? You're groggy because it just got up. The bolt sails right between two of its legs.
Nice.
Yep. Anything else on your turn?
Yeah, I guess I can move, huh?
You can.
Right there.
Okay. All right, Colleen.
I'll move over here.
Okay.
And I'm going to drop Aura of Shade.
Okay, interesting. I've got to remind myself. Do you have the spell card made up?
Yeah, coming up for you. Around myself and Halael here, and I'm going to try to stabilize him.
Okay, so is it centered on you?
Yes.
Okay. Got it. So let me think here. You have the healing kit, right?
Yes.
So I have to remind myself what actually that lets you do. I think that just lets you stabilize him without a roll, if I remember.
I believe so too.
Yep, it does. So Halael, you are stable, and I also have to remind myself this actually hasn't come up for me. Does that mean you have one hit point or just zero, but you're not dying?
I think one. It restores him to one with the healer's kit.
I feel like I'm dying.
Oh, no.
Poison notes.
No, you have zero hit points. You can't make actions, but you're not actually dying right now. As Colleen rushes over to you and takes a few seconds to tend to you and throw a little bit of, antidote on your wound.
Throw some shade.
Hey, I'm invisible.
That's right. Can you do that as a bonus action? The Aura of Shade is one action, and Healer's Kit is an action. Actually, you can't do both. You have to choose.
Okay.
My bad.
Well, then, this changes a few things. I will just step back over to Fallon over here. I'm sorry,
okay.
Stalker.
I'm dying again.
And I'm going to launch a chill touch at that spider to the right here.
This one?
Yes, that one.
Okay. All right. So it's. Okay. Let me see. Yeah, range spell attack. And yeah, you miss. You're still not, unfortunately, not on your game with the whole range spell attack thing.
Apparently.
All right.
At least I'm consistent.
Yep.
I don't want to die.
Well.
Don't kill me too, please.
It is now second group of spiders' turn, and. Hello, Kane.
No.
Damn. I got the rolls tonight.
That does hit.
Make a constitution saving throw. Okay. So, yeah, you also get a nice leg full of spider fang, but unlike Halael, you are strong, you resist the effects of the poison, you brace yourself for that spider's buddy.
No, please. I don't want it.
And that spider happily is a much clumsier one, and you nimbly dodge out of it.
Doesn't critically hit me yet. Sounds good.
Nope.
You got off light.
Okay. So now it is Kane's turn.
So these two guys count as like being next to Halael, right? Adjacent to the
however, Halael is not.
Peter
conscious.
Dictates to his computer. He prefers it to typing.
So for sneak attack
prefers
purposes,
it to pen and paper.
What, can I get that bonus on those two?
No.
Sorry.
Dang it. I'm gonna like run behind everyone over here. And then shoot an arrow at that one.
Okay,
the,
are you
the
using
one.
Cunning action to disengage? Is that what's going on here?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Yeah, you can do that.
Yay. And then arrow to the injured spider.
Okay, yep. Arrow away. Okay, roll damage.
Did it hit?
Yep.
Oh, yeah, how much damage did I take?
You took six.
I took six from that and then from the poison?
Not
or I didn't take anything from poison. Hold on, say six. All right.
So how much damage for your short bow?
Oh, sorry.
Okay, yep. So you bravely run away and whip out your bow, fire at the hurt one, because you always go after the hurt one. And an arrow goes straight through its torso. It goes, or whatever noise spiders make. I'm not good at spider noises. And gives up the spider ghost. So spider down. All right. And we are to Johan, who is bravely going to run up to defend his fallen comrade. So he will, let me see here, go ahead and make a Warhammer attack. Oh, and he will crit. I got all the rolls tonight.
Splatter.
let me see here. I will, and you know what? I'll go ahead and
double kill.
He will go ahead and expend a spell slot as well. To use Divine Smite. So, yeah, let me see here. Yeah, and it doesn't even matter what that was. Actually, you know what? No, I won't make him use Divine Smite. Yeah, so he just runs up and, not divinely, but smites one of the spiders that's costing Kaleo. And that one also just sort of flattens under his Warhammer blow. All right, and actually...
Damn it, man. Where's my kill wounds?
We don't have any of those.
We can we'll save you later. You know, just don't die.
Why are there purple lines coming from up there?
Wait, aren't there lines from up there? No, hold on. I'm trying to hide behind you.
Jada's like, no.
That's the wrong angle.
No hope, please.
At this point, boom!
Rope bunny, no!
The spider is going to attack the thing that was closest to it. So yeah, let me see here. Oh, but happily this one was disoriented as well. So now we're to these spiders.
Wait, there are more?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, good.
So this one is going to charge up towards the fire and attack Fallon.
But it's exhausted.
Stand in the fire. And
Fallon, I think a 19 hits.
Yes.
Okay, so this spider also runs up, lunges, gets you right in the torso, sinks the old fangs in, so you take 6 damage from the bite, and then please make a constitution saving throw.
Okay. What do I click on for that?
There should be a little section. Let me see where it is.
It's just to the right of your dexterity.
Yeah, that says saving throws. Just click on constitution.
Oh, sorry. I didn't see the label at the bottom.
All right, and you know what? At this point, you start to debate the wisdom of frequently doing narcotics as you find yourself weakened and unable to resist the poison that goes coursing through your body.
You mean it didn't like give me a passive resistance? Oh, well.
Unfortunately, not the spider poison. So take an additional 4 poison damage.
Oh, Jesus, man.
Am I the only one that actually has not been poisoned after being bitten? Come on, guys.
Yeah, that's correct. Let me see. Yep, you do still have hit points left. All right.
We're not gonna
only half of us are poisoned.
And this
how many spiders are there?
We'll just come bravely charging up. You guys... I mean, not like you had a choice, but unfortunately nobody critted when you were picking your campsite, so I got to use my spider encounter.
I like this a lot, actually.
I did have you make your survival check because you could potentially have averted it being quite so bad with a really good check, but Otherwise, I was totally going with this encounter.
All right, GG boys. We're not.
All right. And now, Halael, make a death saving throw.
Don't die, buddy.
Ah, yes. Ha.
That is, in fact, a success. So, mark that down. And, Alistair.
Yeah, I'm going to try and grab Halael's body and drag him somewhere in this direction if I can. Maybe back here.
All right, well, wait, let me see here. You spent 15 feet of movement to get to him. And dragging him, you at most you can get him 10 feet from his current location. All and right. Actually, you'll have to make a strength check to do that.
Oh boy, well. I'm gonna try. Can I get advantage on this via my Tides of Chaos? Would that count as a skill check?
Yeah.
All right, then we're gonna try and do this with advantage.
Oh boy. Believe in you.
How much do you weigh, hello?
Let's see, what does it say?
Not a lot. He's no.
He's a
monk. It says 118 pounds.
Okay.
Whatever that means.
Alistair, you run up to Halael and...
Grab him with my good arm.
Yeah, yeah. You grab him with your good arm, you start to pull, and you realize that he's not that heavy, but you're pretty weak. And this probably isn't going to work. I will allow you to abort mission. You will be at your current location, but you can still use your action.
All right. Well, that plan I tried, and then in the meantime, I'm gonna firebolt the one in front of him. And try and get it off him.
Yeah, yeah. All right. So, yep, that'll hit. Go ahead and roll damage. Okay. So yeah, you run over to him. You start tugging on him. You're like, this isn't going to work. So you're like, firebolt. That's a good plan. And yeah, this spider is now extremely singed, but still obviously moving. And it is now that spider's turn.
Oh, I figured this was a bad plan, but...
So it'll sidestep, and it's angry at you. It is angry at you, sir.
That's fair.
15 hit.
Well, it would if I wasn't going to do this.
Shield.
All right. The extremely angry and singed spider, ignoring its desire to feast on Halael's twitching body, jumps around and dives at you, and you realize, oh crap, this thing's gonna get me. Flip up your shield, and it sort of bounces away.
Is this where I make a wild magic roll? Since I just used Tides of Chaos, too?
Yes, this is. roll a d8, sir. And actually, I should have... Oh, yeah. Okay. Okay. Nothing happens.
Clinical success.
Success. All right.
Okay. And Fallon.
So, first question. Can I do my other spell and an attack, or just one or the other?
I think that the other spell that you have works as a bonus action. So, you can use it and then attack.
Second question. Do I sound better?
Yes.
Perfect. Okay. So I would like to do the ensnaring strike on... Can I see this one down here yet?
If you actually can see it, then yeah, you can see it.
Okay. Well, I'm going to go for this one here anyway. I'm going to go for that one.
Are you trying to shoot it?
With the ensnaring strike, right?
Yeah, the only thing keep in mind is you've got one right in your face, and when you have an enemy within melee range, I believe ranged attacks have disadvantage.
Because
you're trying to like fire at something far away.
Okay, well, what about...
I think ensnaring strike does actually work if you want to melee an enemy, though.
I guess I should look at it. Is it a modification of an attack, or is it separate?
Yeah, basically, as a bonus action, you, like, weave magic into your attack. And then when you hit with it, the magic, like, releases. So if you go over to your spells, it's, like, the third bubble from the left.
Okay.
If you click on it, you can bring up the text for Ensnaring Strike.
I thought I did, but maybe I didn't do it right. It keeps rolling.
Oh, you know what? That's why. Hold on a sec.
Did I do it wrong?
Not necessarily, but let me just change it for the time being.
You don't have to sugarcoat it for me. Kidding.
All right, so there
okay,
you go.
Okay, so then I'm going to, I guess, get my axe out and melee this one.
Okay, yep. Go ahead and make an attack.
Working on it. Thunk.
Thunk.
Okay, yeah. You reach behind your back. You quickly stick away your crossbow. Pull out. Yeah, you do exactly that. Roll damage. Sir.
Okay.
You should just have to click on thunk in that sidebar. It should come up with the damage roll.
If you just click on the, in the chat, if you click on the word thunk.
Oh, okay. Done.
Okay. And here is its strength save. So it's going to succeed on the strength save.
Oh my god. did you like accidentally put in some level 10 spiders and I mean, you can be honest with us.
Casey's running Game Shark GM right now.
Okay, yeah. So, yeah, you bring your axe down on the thing. You get a good solid hit right on the middle. Your axe does sort of glance away to the side just a little bit. And you look at the spider as it flexes all the muscles in its body. Its chitinous skeleton sort of rigidifies and it shakes off your magic. Two of them are dead. I put little skull and crossbones on them. Okay. Are you doing anything else on your turn? You have movement. You'll take an opportunity attack if you move away from the spider, though.
Oh, gosh. Okay. Well, I guess... Well, I mean, I have... I don't know what to say. I guess I'll chance it because I'm going to die if I don't. So I guess I'll move there.
All right. The spider bites you as you run away.
My armor class is 16. Does that matter?
Yeah, that's I shouldn't have assumed, but yeah, on ties the attack wins.
So I'm gonna die.
Probably.
I'm gonna have some like awesome last words for you. Dead.
Go ahead and make a con save.
Working on it.
Okay.
Hey.
You do succeed that. So yeah, you just sort of crumple where you are. You are also down. By the way, you guys know that you can force feed each other potions, right?
Yeah, but who has potions in this day and age?
Okay.
Truth.
The con save made it so that you won't be considered poisoned when you get up, which being poisoned is a bad thing and imposes various disadvantages on you.
Yep.
Okay, cool.
We'll demonstrate how bad being poisoned is if I ever get up.
Didn't he already get poisoned before? Or did he save the check?
Can you put a little skull on me?
You take poison damage if you fail the save, but you're only considered poisoned if that reduces you to 0 hit points.
Right, but I am at 0 hit points, right?
Right, so. but you resisted on that one, so yeah. You're good.
Okay.
All right, Colleen.
Okay, I'm going to step here, and now I'm going to throw some shade.
Okay. Wait, I'm not in the shade now, I don't think.
And that's my turn.
All right, so that's a 10-foot radius.
Oh, I'm having the shade.
Okay. All right. That's all then?
Yep. That's all
okay.
then.
All right. It is Blue Spider's turn. Let me see here. What sensors do these things have? Okay, so you are going to be invisible to it, despite its dark vision.
I think we become invisible at the start of our turns.
Oh. Yup. Okay, yep. So the sphere is, like, emanating out from Colleen.
Yep.
All right, well,
gonna take a sec.
Thank you for your honesty. I'm attacking
you guys.
Yeah, I didn't mean to break the same team rule.
I believe in you, Jato.
So the
spider that's not gonna hit me.
Takes a clumsy lunge at you. You didn't even need your shield. The other blue spider is dead, so it is now
totally
Kane's
not
turn.
Cast that three more times. Don't worry.
Kane. All right, so Kane, you are now invisible. That being said, do note that the spell says that if you attack, cast the spell, or leave the area, you're not invisible anymore.
I'm not leaving.
You're too busy dying. All right, can I move here and then stab that spider? No, not that one. Hold on, that one's dead.
If you move, you'll take an attack from the spider next to you.
I got the disengage thing, don't I?
Also, you're invisible.
Yeah, you can disengage.
So you,
as a bonus action.
No, he's invisible, so he won't.
Oh, yeah, that's actually true. Because this, well, no, but the spider's in melee with him. It has a. He would if he didn't
okay.
use his bonus
All
action.
Right.
I gotta move there. I'll move there, disengaging with my
okay.
awesomeness, and stab that spider. In the face. That one's alive, right? Yeah,
yep.
That one's alive.
It's alive.
I'll stab that one.
You know what? Here, I'll just,
in his face.
I'll just remove these. Okay, do you need me to move you?
No. I was going to do my... You got it.
Okay.
I'm there now.
Alright, cool. Yep, stabby stab away.
Stab, stab.
You're so
yeah, stab, stab.
Okay, yep. Go ahead and roll damage.
Stab, stab. And seek attack because it's adjacent to Fallon.
Yeah, let's see how much you overkill it.
All right.
It may or may not have 3 hit points left.
You could also get sneak attack for being invisible, so you're welcome.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because Fallon's not giving you any adjacent bonus since he's.
Yeah, and I guess the invisibility does like recover at the beginning of this turn. So.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So
yeah. Spot her up.
You saunter right up to it. You jam your rapier
into its eyeballs.
Yes, into its eyeballs.
All eight of them.
Yep.
And it gives a spidery squeal and gives up the ghost.
However, any spiders starting in this range will also turn invisible.
Well, if you're right next to them, then I would say you'd be able to see them.
Wait, I'm not invisible now, right?
No, you're invisible.
I'm the only
you're
one
visible
now, right?
Well, no.
No, I haven't turned invisible yet.
Actually,
yeah, no
the only one who's invisible is Clean.
Okay, good.
So are you going to move anywhere else before you end your turn?
Eep.
Yep, okay.
Hiding behind teammates.
You hide behind teammates.
Kind of start crowding around. Every party member for themselves.
We're just trying to make sure you're okay.
Alright, so Johan is going to continue to defend his fallen comrade by.
I'm so glad Johan was here.
No one will stabilize him.
Nope, no one.
Toxic beep.
And let me see. Oh,
can I stabilize him?
Unfortunately, this attack misses.
How does one stabilize somebody?
So you can there are a couple ways. You could feed him a potion, in which case he'll actually recover hit points and be able to do stuff. Or you can just try to give first aid, basically. In which case it's a medicine check to try to.
I have a ceremonial knife.
What?
You have a ceremonial knife.
Yeah, can I use that to stabilize him?
You could use that to sacrifice him.
You could coup de grace him.
I also have a bell.
For Harambe.
I don't know why.
So, unfortunately, Johan's attack missed, and it is now Green Spider's turn.
Who is at least not invisible, so.
And let me see, actually.
Good for us.
Yeah, he saw Kane, doing
no.
his Pursue.
Thing. You're the only one he can get to. What am I supposed to do? Killeen's invisible.
Fallon is down. Halayla's down.
Oh yeah, Fallon's down.
Yeah. So yeah. No. The spider's gonna go after you.
It hurts.
So you take this many damages. As the spider bites into your ankle. Go ahead and make a con save.
Is Come that on, spider standing on top of a rock? Please? Or is that like an obstacle?
If only you had advantage.
If only politeness granted advantage.
Come on.
If only. So, you know, the bite didn't hurt too bad, but unfortunately the poison kind of does. So take an additional 5 poison damage.
I'm not feeling too good, guys.
All right.
I'm not feeling too hot.
Halayl, you are stable.
Death saving throw? Oh, no, what?
You are stable.
What?
Who stabilized him?
Oh, wait, you're not stable. Death saving
throw. Life goes on.
What am I talking about?
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
Good job, buddy.
Halayl continues to resist one more. The icy grip of death.
He continues to not die.
And Alistair, it's your turn. You gotta.
And I see my. Well, Halayl's visible now, right?
Well, he's also right next to you, so.
Okay.
Oh yeah, Halayl would be invisible to most.
That would make so it we... hard to
but
try
you,
and
but you,
grab
like,
him.
We're
and...
just touching him, so you can.
Okay.
Yeah, you're good.
Oh man.
You think right, I haven't we're... moved much?
Okay. All right, I'm gonna try and spend my turn. Let's see. Does making a skill check make me visible again?
No.
No, I'm going to try and stabilize him.
Okay.
Sorry, this is going to be bad, but I'm going to do it.
I mean, that was my plan.
Yeah.
Okay, unfortunately.
You can try and stabilize Fallon.
I don't think that's good enough.
I don't think it is either.
Because I think it's DC 15.
Casey, is that spider standing on a rock? Like, is that an
element? Oh, yeah, it's scurried up the rock. It's not a huge rock. But yeah, it's totally on a rock.
It's totally on a rock, guys.
Oh, wait, no. Actually, it is a DC 10 check.
Hey!
All right, so, Alistair, you know, you didn't learn a whole lot of first aid, but you got a little bit while you were sailing, and you think that you may have done a decent enough job of patching up Halayl's wound and... You know, you tie off a little tourniquet to make sure the poison won't spread too far.
I'm going to pretend I did all that while he's invisible, and it was fine.
It's all over my body. It's just not going to spread to my ankle now.
That's right.
It's fine.
That's right. Fallon, I got a flavor justify it somehow, right?
Yeah.
Make a death saving throw.
Okay. I'm looking for it.
It's right above... your,
did I do
your
it?
Attacks.
Yep, that is a success.
You live?
So mark down.
What's
one.
A fail?
Fail is 9 or less.
Oh.
Boosh.
I don't want to die, guys.
The odds are very slightly stilted in your favor.
I don't think I'll
so, yeah.
succeed.
If yes. I fall. Fallon, you too resist the icy grip of death, at least for the moment. Clean.
All right. Assuming that the spider is looking at Kane, I'm going to make myself very small against this rock and cast silent image of myself appearing where I was previously standing. So it should be visible, and it's going to run this way.
Can you show the text for silent image real quick?
Yes.
Okay, so let's see here. All right, so you make an image of yourself here, and it goes running off
this way.
This way, okay. So are you using... Are you having it go its full movement, move more carefully?
Actually, let's put it over by Fallon so it doesn't provoke opportunity attacks as it runs by.
Okay, so you're going to have it here.
Yeah.
And it's going to run that. Okay, so you're going to have it run to this point?
Just at its full move distance, of, as if it were me, 30.
Okay.
All right. Let's go about 15.
Okay. I
want to call it off.
Okay, so let me see. Johan, I guess, 30. Sees Colleen go running off this way. The
bye, buddy.
These spiders also notice this. All right, I'm just trying to think how this works. Okay, all right. So that totally happens.
That's all I got for
you. Johan goes off and gets himself killed. Remember this.
But I can save the rest of the people. All
right, Kane.
Bouncy, turn it down. Turn.
With trickery, without hurting things.
All right, my green spider is still alive and kicking.
Correct.
Gosh. Has it taken any damage so far?
Nope. Although, you do have an ally by it.
I do. I'm wondering if, because I'm invisible now again. And I'm wondering if I should break that invisibility. Or not.
Actually, wait a minute. Let me think.
How long does that last for, actually?
Until you leave the area.
Oh, wait. Actually, wait a minute. Does that require concentration? Aura of Shade is a concentration spell.
Oh, I can't maintain both.
You can't maintain both.
So I'm not invisible anymore?
Since this is the first time you've done it, I will let you choose to either have the aura drop or, like, I'll let you redo your turn if you want to. But as it is, the
aura
will drop.
Curse you, fifth edition.
Okay. Fuck it. I'm going to move over here to Fallon.
Okay.
And I'm going to
silent image.
Yep, I'm going to throw an ice knife at this square here.
Okay, can you show me ice knife again?
Nope.
Okay, so that's against a target.
I'm aiming at the square here so that it bursts. And.
Oh, okay, so you're just trying to hit him with the burst damage. Yeah. Okay, go ahead and still give me an attack roll for the sake of judging your accuracy.
Sounds like a plan.
Critical
really
success?
This part.
Okay, yeah, you are extremely accurate. So let me see here. They have to make a dex save. So we're going to hit these two spiders, it looks like. So let me see here. The dex is plus 3.
You're not adjacent anymore. No.
What's your spell save?
14.
All right, yeah, they both fail. Roll 2d6. Okay. So yeah, you see Colleen throw out a shard of ice. It smacks into the ground. The fragments come up and bloody the spiders a bit. Actually, that one's dead now.
Hooray!
So that's good.
We're doing it, boys.
All right. And actually, wait a minute.
Back to Kane. I'm sorry. Cool. Can't concentrate.
I just realized I may have accidentally removed some spiders from the initiative order. Because of the way that I did the groups. And this one's 4. And I think I may have skipped that one's turn, but I'll let you off the hook this time.
It's okay, I can only repeat my turn so many times.
Yeah. All right. Okay. Now it's your turn, Kane.
Okay. I'm gonna run over here.
Okay. So you're disengaging again?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm gonna stab that one.
Okay.
In the GABA.
And yeah, let me actually see here. So you're... I realize I maybe should have given this to you last time. You're hidden. So should that give you...
He's invisible, so I think he gets sneak attack.
The old... Well, it's not just sneak attack.
Oh, okay.
I'm trying to decide...
Advantage everything.
You know what? I will give you... Or actually, wait a minute. No, actually, I'm not going to give you advantage. There's a reason that I'm not telling you. But yeah, attack away. You will have sneak attack.
Okay. Stab. Does it stab?
Yep. Stab away.
It stabs. Then sneak attack.
Yep.
It stabbed it.
Yep, and it given your angle, you run your sword clean along the length of its body. You feel the life energy pulse out of it, and the spider drops dead.
I stabbed it good.
Yes, you're welcome.
No, please save me from dying. Please, you're going to try and kill me. I don't want to die.
Anything else?
Can I move? I already moved. I used all my actions, didn't I?
You have a little bit of movement left. You are allowed to split up your movement in 5th edition. So you have 15 feet of movement left if you want.
Ooh, right there.
Okay, cool. And
Protect my body.
Hide behind Fallon's decomposing body. I mean...
It is now Johan's...
Mostly dead body.
And he will step over here. And he'll actually go ahead and put away his shield and make a two-handed swing. And he will connect.
Smash.
For 13 damages. So yeah, Johan steps over and he also drops a spider. Alright. And now... Only when Laugh doesn't wake up. Alright. Let me see, sir. So now we're on these spiders.
As soon as he said he's going to take a 3-hour nap, I'm just like...
Oh god, there are more.
Wait, what? No. No. I thought I was safe over here.
So
better you than me.
Why do you do this to me, Casey?
I like being invisible. This is great.
What do you think its movement speed is, by the way, Kane? The movement speed is 40 feet, as it turns out. So it turns out they had one more friend.
No!
Who comes charging out of the woods. It was waiting by its web, but you guys decided not to go that way. And this one will step up here and attack Lean. Because, as it turns out, they have blindsight.
Wait, so that spider didn't attack me? I mean...
No, they're attacking you. I'm just lining up the attacks first. So, Kane, here's the one against you. How does 13 compare to your AC?
Doesn't hit.
All right. You nimbly dodge away as the spider goes lunging past you. Lean, here's against you. And I think that misses as well.
It does.
All right. Yep. Clumsy spiders. Their friends are going down around them. They're fighting boldly, bravely. But this does not seem like their day.
They can't kill me.
Paleo, you're stable.
Yay.
I'm gonna make another passive check.
Okay. Alright. Don't kill him. So... Oh, you killed him.
Yeah. You go over, foul in, you fail two death save. I'm just kidding.
I don't really know how close he is, so I'm kind of fumbling more around in the invisibility for this guy. He's somewhere. I can find the wound.
That exactly.
Yeah. Foul pretty in, sure he's here, but saving throw.
Is that blood? That's wet.
I feel something wet.
Okay, mark down one failure.
Awesome.
Colleen, it's your turn.
Okay, I'm going to use Booming Blade on this spider next to me.
Okay.
Here's Booming Blade for you.
You're supposed to attack the one next to me.
So are you attacking with like a...
A dagger.
Okay. Okay, yeah, you're like, you know what, I've been having a little trouble with my spells except for that ice blade, let me go for this. You reach out, and the spider sort of jumps back as you swing past it. Unfortunately, it's not very effective.
I'm going to make an offhand dagger attack.
Okay.
Falls.
It jukes to the side.
It's a wily spider.
Anything else?
That's all I got for you.
Alright. Kane?
Okay, how do death saving throws work? Like, do you just, like, if you fail two, you did?
If you fail three,
you fail three.
If you fail three or four, you succeed
three and become stable.
Yeah, and the other thing that I haven't mentioned is, I'm pretty sure I'm right about this, a 20 counts as succeeding twice and a 1 counts as failing twice. So, right now, Fallon does have a 1 in 20 chance of not living.
Okay.
I'm just walking
away. Disengage.
I get one more chance to stabilize him before then.
It's true. Well, lots of you, several of you have actions before that comes up. So
I'm gonna disengage this guy.
Okay.
Go over here. I'm gonna stab this one in the face.
Go for it.
Stab. No.
Let me think. Yeah, that's gone. So, yep. That spider has the jukes.
How much more running do I have? I went 10 feet, so you have 20, right?
Invisible in a second.
You can run some more.
Sneak attacking it.
I'm probably not going to let you run all the way here, because you kind of already ran diagonal a bit, but like here is probably fine.
Alright, yeah, I'm going to go cower next to Halil's dead body.
I'm not dead.
I'm not dead.
You're not dead yet?
Alright, let me see.
Here. I feel happy.
Yeah.
But the cart's over here.
Johan will run up here. Make another Warhammer attack. Once again, I roll high. And dear God, I'm killing all of them.
Thanks. Oh, you were the one who put them on us. You should finish them off.
Okay. Who will Casey kill faster? The players or spiders?
Well, I am just down to one spider. And that spider is going to... Let me see, what is that spider going to do, actually? That spider is starting to smell the dead bodies of spiders. And despite its low intelligence, it realizes that this is not its day. So it is going to disengage from Colleen. And
attack of opportunities?
No, it's disengaging. Actually, it's going to head this way.
No.
You do... I forget. Did I hide that area?
I can see half the spider.
Okay. That's about appropriate for the situation, actually. You see it skitter off into the trees. Halil, you are stable, as you have been for a fair amount of this fight.
Are you sure he's not dead?
No, not a fair amount. I've been stable for two turns now.
he's almost there anyway.
You know, a few more.
All right, Alistair, it is now your turn.
So
the spider's running away. That seems to be the last one.
Yeah, but they keep coming out of the places that I can't see, and so I'm going to firebolt this thing just in case it tries to bring friends back.
Okay.
Who wants to save Fowler?
You did see it disappear, so no disadvantage. Go ahead and just attack away. Ooh. Yep, that'll hit.
Bam.
And yeah, so you hurl your firebolt off into the woods. You hear the spider scream in pain. You do hear it continue to scream as it scurries off into the forest. So yeah, pretty sure you didn't actually down it.
Worth a shot.
Fallon, death saving throw time.
Think life, living thoughts.
Okay. There we success go. Number two. Colleen, it's your turn.
I'm going to send a chill touch after the spider. I can see its butt still.
Okay.
She'll can have away. Some flame and frost.
Icy hot.
Exactly. And you see the hand reach out and hit dirt just behind the spider's legs as it runs away. All right.
I hate this. Why do I roll such shit?
I killed lots of spiders.
Kane, it's your turn.
So, we still seem to be in combat.
Until you guys say that you're not in combat, there is an enemy. It is fleeing, but I'm giving you options to do things.
Yeah.
Okay. Can I, heal myself somehow? I don't know. Or ask someone for like a potion? Or is that not able to be done in combat?
You can...
Like asking someone for
a potion. I mean, so combat is... Each round is supposed to represent 6 seconds. So you can say anything that could be said in 6 seconds.
I hurt. Please help.
Doesn't have to be a fragment.
But I hurt really bad.
I won't like hold you to that strictly. If you want to speak in an intelligible sentence for the sake of the group, that's fine. I'm willing to suspend.
I mean, I'm really close to like being a Hallel right now. So I think it's speaking.
Well, we still have a Hallel benchmark to work with here.
Yeah. and we have Fowler is still bleeding out, but I can't see him yet.
Okay. Oh, I could. So the wait, rest no, of I'm you. Gonna try to... You hear Kane whine like a little bitch about a flesh.
Yep.
Yes, and now I'm gonna go try to stabilize Fowlin.
Okay.
I'm a nice person.
Try to find him.
He's invisible still.
And I can't even see the spider, so like I'm not even gonna try to hit it. Like,
you can't see Fowlin.
Yeah, you
hold
can
on.
Make, like,
in my death throes, can they hear me evacuating my bowels or
wait, how do I can
maybe
I stab-
smell.
How can I stabilize Fowlin since I can't see him?
You look for
well. You were
yeah. Ask the wizard for stuff. You know,
he's got this like there's there, buddy.
I was right there, but
oh, wait,
I didn't
no,
where
you
he
can
was.
See him. The darkness dropped. You can totally see him.
When did it drop?
Next to the fire.
Oh wait, no, it didn't drop. You're right. Honest.
It didn't drop.
I can't dispel it on my
that's
turn.
That's a good point.
But...
okay, you know where he
Fowlin,
was.
Gurgle.
I feel so
make
cold.
Make a perception check.
Gurgle, Fowlin. Gurgle for your life.
Make a perception, Kane. We believe in you.
Okay, yeah. You know about where he was when he fell, and so you stumble into the darkness, feel around a little bit. Oh, there he is. You remember for a bit. Okay, he got hit at about the waist. You look in close. You know,
find
you,
the waist.
You can make out where the wound is, and you do your best to tend to it. Make a medicine check.
All right. I'm good at these too, right? Hold on. Am I?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not terrible at them.
You are, in fact, terrible at them.
Do I need to make a death saving throw?
Not yet.
On your turn.
Okay.
Yeah, I still have a chance.
So I am going to go ahead and say...
Healing guy, heal things.
I'm going to go ahead and say that at this point, the spider has gotten away. Does anyone object to that?
Yeah.
No, okay. I'm dying.
So you're not actually dying. All right, so we're now...
I feel like I'm dying, okay.
We're now out of initiative. That spider.
Okay, I thought you kept the initiative because there are, like, more spiders in the darkness.
Well, I don't
I was
know.
Like,
there are some dark areas that I didn't pull anything out of.
Because, I mean, we can, like... Is there an equivalent of taking a 20 or taking a 10 to stabilize Fallon?
Yeah, you know what? Actually, just, like... Well, here. I'll do Johan's medicine check.
Doesn't
he have a spell to heal people?
Yeah, he could lay a hands in.
There we go. Oh my god.
Full health, right? That's how that works.
He's made Fallon better than he was before.
Johan
we
heals
have
the
technology.
Shit out of Fallon. Alright, so Fallon, you're now stable as well. Okay, so at this point... You have two unconscious teammates. The four of you are huddled by your fire.
I'm bleeding as well. It hurts.
You have gotten perhaps.
Jato, did you take damage?
Nope.
High five.
The dream's still alive.
Just one half of Team No Hit still going strong.
Come on without me.
Save yourselves.
You've gotten about 3 or 4 hours of sleep at this point. You need more rest in order to benefit from... Well, actually, you didn't take any damage before, so that's fine. But this is the situation. Go.
Hey, guys.
I slumped down.
Can...
That's it.
I just kind of look at...
And then I just lay down, go to sleep.
I look at my wounds, and I say, hey, guys, how do I stop these from... I don't feel very well, guys. You think it's safe for me to, like, go to sleep?
Can I talk here since I'm stable?
I don't know.
Can the stable people use their dice to heal themselves over a rest or no? Since they're not resting.
If you stay long enough for this to be a short rest, which for sake of my game, I'm going to say is like 45 minutes, then yeah, you can totally use hit dice.
Including the unconscious folk.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Well, all right, so here's the way this is going to work. You're like midway through a long rest. If you extend... If you extend that long rest, then you will be able to recover eventually. You will just get a late start on the next day. By the way, I'm just going to mention this because this is going on in whispered chat. You do see, as you're pondering what to do next, Colleen actually wanders over towards one of the dead spiders, pulls out a bottle. Actually, make a perception check, everyone who's conscious and who isn't Colleen.
Woo!
Yeah.
Perception checks. Me.
Okay. Am I conscious or not?
No, you are not.
No.
That's cool.
You see a pale blue mist escape from the spider and enter the bottle that Colleen is holding.
Hey, Colleen, what you doing?
Oh, nothing. Don't worry about it.
She's collecting spider blood or something.
It's just a little bit of research.
So you guys see me kill all those spiders? Me and everybody killed like all of them.
Yes, you're welcome for that invisibility. It's really helpful in a pinch.
That was handy.
Yeah, while you were, I was trying to make sure that the people who are dying didn't die.
I was too.
Well,
yeah, no,
I mean,
I'm looking at Kane firmly.
Maybe the ones who were bragging about not ever getting hit should have practiced not getting hit when the spider showed up.
We didn't get hit.
Looking at Haleo.
Oh.
You look pretty worse for wear.
I'm unconscious.
I never claimed to never be able to get hit. I'm saying, me and Rope Buddy, like,
I'm got kicking a man
lots
like that.
Of spiders.
Yeah. I need to rest after that ordeal. And
do you guys
would
think
say
they should,
that
like,
Fallon and Haleo probably need it too.
Do you
Are
think
you guys able to maintain watch?
Oh gosh, but watch.
Johann, I need a little bit of rest, but I should be alright.
Yeah, Johann looks over as well and he's like, I can watch for a while if you all need to sleep.
That was a great laugh impression.
Johann, went to the rescue again.
So I look around at the people who are still awake. Do you guys know how to, like, anything about, like, healing and medicine and stuff?
No idea.
Okay.
I love medicine. Everything about life. Fascinating.
Can I just, like, sleep off these injuries, or should I get, like...
Oh, yes, you should be quite fine, I believe.
It might be effective if you just went to sleep.
I wasn't poisoned, right?
No, you're not poisoned.
Okay, cool. I thought I was poisoned.
Poison damage, but it doesn't actually poison you unless it reduces you to 0 hit points.
Oh.
I'm the one who's poisoned.
So Stalker will be poisoned.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'm going to sleep now.
Okay.
I got to, like, I don't know, curl up. Maybe, like, kind of, like, out of sight, though, in case more stuff shows up. So, like, it won't see me. Somewhere, maybe, like, next to that rock. Try to, like, hide sleep.
Give me a stealth check.
All right, stealthy sleeping. I'm good at stealth checks.
You curl up against the rock and go to sleep.
All right, I hope I'm stealthed.
Who knows?
I don't think I am, but I hope I am.
All right, let me see here. Okay. So, yeah, the rest of you plop down. And you're just out, let me see here. So it's probably like, Colleen, at about 5 in the morning, at about 5 in the morning, you come out of your meditation and you look over and realize that Johann has just been sort of stolidly keeping vigil the entire night, rest of the night while you guys were sleeping. I'm going to narrate for you, but so just tell me if this isn't what you do, but you sort of tap him on the shoulder and nod, and he slumps over and immediately goes to sleep himself. And you you know, watch for a while longer. Go ahead and give me a perception check as well.
Notice the spiders this time.
Okay. And you have some idea what to listen for this time, but you don't hear the spiders continuing. I mean, you don't think you hear any spiders. Finally, it gets to late in the morning. It's maybe 10 a.m. There were some members of your group who were pretty beat up. But you finally stir awake. Fowlin and Haleo, you wake up as well. Put yourselves at half your HP rounded up. Kane, you completely recover during the night.
Woo!
You look around and realize that rock was pretty small and probably not doing you much good, but nothing bad happened. Woo! I will go ahead and just so you know what was around. Can you see everything now?
Yes.
I see that spider.
Ah, spider. Kill it.
Everyone kill it.
It's gone.
Fire.
Can
I find my knife?
Oh, actually, it is there, though. It's just like in a hole. You do notice these white boxes are areas of giant spider webs that you missed the night before, apparently.
White boxes?
I don't see the white boxes.
I see one in the
Oh, box. That's right. They're on the GM layer. I forgot about that. So
there is one.
Oh, okay. Well, so like for instance.
So we could have walked into spider webs and
that one.
Stuff.
Just as a for example, there's one right there. Yep, you could have walked into spider webs. It would have been not very happy, but you all stayed around the fire. So, and you all sort of groggily wake up and.
I'm going to look for my dagger.
Okay, give me perception.
No.
Give me a, let me see here. Okay, you notice it. However, it is right in the middle of this web.
Can I try to like cut the webbing? It's my rapier.
Let me see here. I have to look up my fancy pants web rules.
Just look on the internet.
Yeah, go for it. Just roll damage. Actually, you know what? No, you cut away at it. You get web stuck on your blade for a while, but you manage to clear enough of it away to eventually come in, grab your dagger back, clean it off. It's a process. It takes you probably 20 minutes to get everything all cleaned off, but you finally get it. It is now late morning.
I successfully did something. It may have been a lock, right?
So everyone else, Kane has been fussing with his dagger this entire time.
While I fussed.
As a Chinese professor of mine said in graduate school, any discussions? Or are you just going to sort of stoically get on the road?
I'm breaking into some meal rations early on and making sure Fowlin and Halal are all right.
I grumble Bring about how lucky that spider got.
I feel a bit groggy.
I at least point out the corpse of the one that killed Halal and say, at least we got that one.
Yeah, and Halal, you can move. I will say you are not actually suffering from the poison status effect. However, you are pretty stiff still.
I'm suffering from the artifacts of the poison after effects.
Yeah. You don't feel 100% at the moment, but you feel like you can probably travel at the very least. Okay. Anything else? Or are we just heading on the road?
Just trying to judge if Hilael's up to joking. I tell him that, you know, you're going to have to lose a little weight. It was pretty tough to get you out of that situation.
I'm going to give him a dying person's death glare, you know.
Okay, not up to joking. Got it. Go back to eating my rations.
Can anyone here cook? We got this fire going still. Can make it this nice little breakfast for the people that almost died.
Oh yeah, your fire's totally burned down at this point.
Oh man.
Yeah, we have rations. Let's eat and get moving so we don't get pushed here again.
Pacing up and down.
I'm sorry?
So you got anything good?
I have your rations.
I have a parfait, but I'm eating it.
Hey, what did Carlin say?
He said he has a parfait.
I have a parfait, but I'm eating it. So.
Oh yeah, so the breakfast food that you said will probably go bad fairly quickly.
Okay. Yeah.
I'm gonna get some of that.
I mean, I'm assuming that's what you're doing. So. All right. So yeah. So you all
eating
sort of
breakfast food.
Limber up. You know, you sort of make like. You try to joke and smile, but you know that you had a bit of a scrape last night, and a few members of your party are not feeling very happy about it. Finally, though, you do sort of start moving. And actually, I am going to say, Fowlin and Hilael, please make constitution checks. And also, are we going at a normal pace today? Are we trying to hurry or anything?
I think we should take it easy.
Okay.
For the guys who are hit by like everything. They didn't dodge anything.
Okay.
Why are we doing the Constitution?
Because we're gonna die.
So basically
I don't have poison.
Yeah, but both of you guys kinda got messed up last night, so I was asking you to do that to see if you notably slowed the party down as you turn on the next day. And as a matter of fact, Hilael is definitely feeling the after effects of the spider. He's charging out. Now, that being said, he was in pretty good shape for this kind of thing before, so it's not slowing you down a ton.
My base movement speed is faster than everyone else. I should be slowed down to their speed.
I give Hilael a big pat in the back, like a hard pat in the back, and say, you'll be okay.
You're slowed down to slightly less than their speed. You notice that you're worse than them, and you feel bad about it. No.
Ouch.
Colleen is going to skip ahead of everyone, and then wait for people to catch up, and then do it again.
Well, you can skip ahead of Hilael, which you couldn't do before.
The last time this picture was up, we got attacked by some tree monster things.
Oh, yeah.
It's such a pretty picture,
those branch
though.
Creatures. We destroyed them, though. Reason. Didn't hit us.
That's true. They did not hit us.
Do it. Fuck them.
All right. So you continue on for this next day. It's still really hot outside, which is pretty unpleasant, but meh. And actually, does anyone want to do anything in particular as you travel on? Or, because otherwise I'm going to have fast travel for a couple days.
So. Can I just ask, though, am I supposed to have any health?
Yeah, and actually, the next night, Fallon and Hilael would recover the rest of their health, so go ahead and just long rest yourselves.
Okay.
Well, what? Yeah, and everyone else did too, right?
Yep. So you're all completely recovered on everything.
Ooh. Feels good being alive.
Okay.
But then, Fallon, I think your death saves reset after a long rest.
Oh yeah, they actually reset as soon as you're stabilized.
Okay. I took them off.
All right. So Yeah, so anything as you travel in particular, or just like normal travel, good stuff.
Clean is rather single-minded.
I whistle a lot.
Destination.
Yeah, I would try and get us to push the pace a bit after the first day when everyone feels a little more recovered, but otherwise normal.
Okay. So you travel the first day, you know that you didn't make very much progress between the late start, and Hilael sort of dragging the party down a little bit. Just that leg, it does not feel right. That being said, on the second day, or actually the third day of travel, Hilael, you feel a lot better. You feel like your old self again. And so at this point, Alistair is proposing to try to get a move on. Let's say the rest of you.
I look at Johan. Kane looks at Johan, and then he gets out his rope and ties it together.
I don't think Johan wants that anymore.
He doesn't need you.
Is this what the terrain looks like, or is it more?
You guys had a fight last time.
Johan's not here, so he does what I want him to do. And I'm going to say he looks at you and says, well, we're talking about trying to hurry it up today, and I don't think being tied together by a rope is the most conducive to that.
We can give it some slack so that, you know, they'll slow each other down.
Make a persuasion check.
Right.
I'm all for speeding up. Feeling better today.
He spreads out his arms to welcome you and says, rope buddy, and lets you tie it.
Yes.
How many times does he get a tree in between them?
Then I look over at Hilael and I'm like,
well, there are many trees actually here. So they could actually potentially make this work. It just would be more difficult.
Making what work?
Walking fast, even though you're tied together.
Oh, we got slack between it. Not like it's like, yeah. Now
I'll pass on the rope, thanks.
Okay.
Okay. So
are you sure?
So are you trying to travel more quickly as Alistair is suggesting?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Yes.
I need to look.
I think that's a good idea.
Because
huff and puff.
All right. So in that case. Okay, I'm sorry. Give me a moment, talk amongst yourselves. I need to look something up.
So what kind of spiders
have us at fight?
Anyone know?
Lucky ones.
Never seen spiders that big before.
Well, I've heard stories of even bigger ones, more dangerous. Those didn't seem.
I would assume I've seen them. Dangerous in the forest.
Oh yeah, totally.
Wait, they get bigger? I don't know.
Yeah.
Cities.
Yeah.
We're into giant spiders.
I'd like to see that.
Okay. All right.
If we do see that, I'd like to see it from a safe distance.
Oh, but it was so much fun
between me and it.
Kane may not be afraid of spiders.
I think we can let Colleen go first. In a lot of situations, guys, I think. That's cool, right? Colleen, you don't mind just checking things out for us?
Oh, of course. I'll have a look.
I'm down with this. I think this is a good idea.
Can't use sarcasm with Colleen. It's not gonna.
I'm not trying to. I mean, I'm manipulating for my own advantage of living.
All right. So the one thing that I am going to need is, let me think about this, make it a dexterity check from, actually make it a saving throw from Kane and Johan.
Shit, it's the police. Let's get out of here.
All right. So yeah, you travel on through the day. You make a pretty good pace for the most part. You do notice as you travel that Johan is having rather a bit of difficulty keeping up while tied to Kane. Definitely slowing you down a little bit.
Who's going to cut the rope?
You can't separate me and rope, buddy.
So does anyone want to do anything about it, or are we just going to struggle onward?
Struggle onward.
I kind of just going to keep going at the correct pace and let him fall a bit behind.
Okay. So that totally happens.
Johan seems reasonable. He'll figure it out. Well, no, he doesn't. He keeps tying himself to other people.
Well, see, here's the thing. Johan is Johan bot right now, and Kane mm-hmm. made a decent persuasion check. So,
yeah, I understand. But I'm not trying to metagame that either.
Yep. So, all right. So you continue on towards the forest. You know, eventually, you do have to slow down a little bit and let Kane and Johan catch up. Finally, after a while of this, after probably like 8 hours of this, Johan sort of shakes his head a little bit and unties the rope and hands it back to Kane.
Give him a hurt look.
His eyes glaze over as he looks off into the distance, as if his mind is controlled by an external force. you make good time throughout most of the day. It does start to cool down a little bit as it gets into the night. And right about dusk, you see the edge of the forest. It's about 2 miles away at this point. So if you pressed on, you could probably make the forest, but it would be dark by the time you got there.
Do you want to risk going through the dark again? I mean, I can't see in the dark, so...
We might have more room to make a campfire if we push on through the forest.
Also, right, we don't have to worry about what comes. We went through the dark. Like, the only way we were able to navigate was when I tied myself to Johan. That's how the rope started.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I mean, if we have to wade through the dark in the forest.
You see well in the dark, right?
Of course.
Yeah. And Colleen loves to go ahead.
We can also just, I'll pull out a torch and light a torch. And hand it to Kane.
I have a torch.
Oh wait, are you continuing to travel into like nighttime?
Just out of the edge of the forest.
Okay.
He's just complaining about it being dark, so
sure.
I'm solving the problem.
Gotcha.
We all can't see in the dark, guys.
Well, I gave you a torch.
I had a torch last time too. Why didn't I use it?
Actually, you
One of the great mysteries.
Also tied yourself to Johan. So.
Wasn't it Johan's idea last time? Whose idea was it actually?
Yeah, well,
so I think we're pushing through the edge of the forest.
All right.
Okay.
So we can make camp on the other side.
Gotcha. Okay, so hearing no objections, you continue to push on into... It's legitimately night by the time you get there. You eventually do make the edge of the forest. You get perhaps a mile in before you sort of start to think, definitely time to make camp, unless you don't want to do that. But
no, let's do that.
Okay, so survival checks. Anyone who wants to work that out?
I don't even attempt it.
Same.
What do we?
I'll try.
Something you should be good at, Fallon.
Okay.
I contributed.
Fallon has advantage on this. You sort of start looking around as you're like, this might be time for the evening, and then Fallon just sort of tosses his head back and he's like, this way. And he guides you into. There's actually. Some rocks that form kind of a shelter there. It's like almost a cave, but not quite. It's still open and definitely set away from the part of the forest that you got into. And you go down for the night there.
How many rations would be down now?
I'm keeping track of that. Basically, I'm just measuring it against days of travel. I'm keeping track of how many days it's been, and I will let you know if I think you're going to have a problem. As it is now, I don't think you'll have a problem.
Okay.
Okay, so let me see here. I have to keep track of this. All right. So, gonna do a little bit more fast travel here.
Before we do, I want to do one thing at the camp that night.
Okay, absolutely.
I would like to talk to Colleen. But Colleen, you tend to be a liker of things, right? Find things interesting.
Well, yes. What do you mean?
Those tricks you pulled back at the spider attack. I thought this might be of interest to you, and I pull out my scroll of comprehend languages.
Oh my, what's this?
This is a scroll that my dear friend Quarren gave me back from Rampart, but I've been holding on to it, haven't had a use yet, but I thought maybe I'd let you take a look.
Oh my god.
You're giving it to me.
I wanted to let you take a look at it and study it. Maybe if, I've heard you can, I know that people, wizards, can usually copy these things. Maybe make some more.
Oh, yes, I could definitely put it in my spellbook. It'd be lovely.
Yeah. So that's pretty much what I want to do.
All right. I will immediately start transcribing.
Okay, you're going to try to stay up and do that? Oh, yeah, actually, you totally can't. Okay, yeah, this will work. Let me think. So it'll be... So it does the... transcribing a spell requires rare, like, inks and such. It requires 50 GP per level of the spell.
Yep.
I'm not going to, force you to have actually bought that in towns and stuff, but if you want to copy it, it'll cost you 50.
Okay. I will copy it.
Okay, but I'll let you do that tonight. So, and you also have a spell that, a scroll that anyone in your party can use for a one-shot. And you would have enough time during the night.
Can you give me that spell information so I can just copy-paste it, Jato?
Yeah. Yeah, I can. I don't have it on my card, but I have the spellbook open, so. Comprehend languages, there it is.
All right, continue.
Okay, anything else that night? I'm just going to go ahead and say I'm not throwing things at you this particular night, so I may need to go through all that.
Oh, okay.
Spoilers.
You gotta leave it in suspense.
Oh, can I? I'm gonna take some gnome salts. Yeah.
Okay. Roll a d20.
Divination ritual.
Divination.
Two. Oh crap! Who's
rolling a d20?
Okay. Okay, so you take out a bunch of gnome salts.
Sweet roll.
And light it up. And you feel your body floating up over the forest. You keep floating up and up and up. Eventually you see the plain stretching away from the forest. You see Rampart to the south. You see the mountains to the east. You continue up. You see the entire island stretching out before you. And then you see it tip. And at the northeast corner at... Is there a glacier there?
Yeah.
Do you know what's up there?
Well...
You see a giant bite get taken out of the island. Giant portion of it just disappears. Another bite. You see the entire island crumbling away before you. And suddenly you come careening back down to Earth, snap back to where you are, and are caught between the adrenaline rush of what you just saw and the contentment of the drugs.
Cool.
And there's your trip.
What just happened?
He took the drugs.
Okay.
Did he smoke the drugs?
Yeah, if anyone...
Next time, can I... Or could I... What happens if I blow a smoke ring in Kane's face?
Does that seem like a good idea to you right now?
Contact high. No, I don't want to share. Never mind. Okay. It's mine. All right. I don't know you guys.
Suffice to say, I mean, were you making any effort to hide what you were doing? Besides just maybe retreating a distance?
No, not too much, I guess.
Okay. Suffice to say, you all can decide what you were doing, but if you were looking, what you would have seen is Fallon sort of reach into a small pouch that he carries with him, take out a pinch of something, hard to tell, from where he was sitting, and light it up and inhale it, basically. All right. Anything else? LOL. Okay. So yeah, you sleep through the night, and actually, again, like, interrupt me. We're traveling pretty long distances, so I'm not gonna detailed narrate all of it. But stop me if you want to do anything. Like, if I say that 3 days pass and there's something you wanted to do on the second day, stop me. And actually, by the way, I'm going to give you a little peek behind the curtain to let you know that sometimes small decisions matter. If you hadn't gone into the forest, you would have been attacked. So, just so you know that things like this are happening.
See, Kane, you almost got us attacked.
Wait, hold on, what?
But being so slow.
We put camp in the forest.
So, yeah, if Alistair had not pushed you all to hurry through the day and continue into the forest at night, you would have been attacked when you made camp on that day. So I'm just giving you a little peek. I'm not going to tell you everything like this, but I want to let you know that these decisions do matter.
Darn, I want to get attacked.
All right. So the next day you wake up and it's been unusually hot this entire time, but things seem to have cooled down as you continue into the next day and as you walk through the forest. The temperature evens out to just sort of a nice, 60 Fahrenheit. What is that, like 16, 18 Celsius, something like that?
Who uses Celsius?
Stalker does. the going is pretty good. That being said, for the next 2 days of travel, you have a general idea where you're going, but you're not on any kind of path. So the navigation is not, how shall I put this? It's not trivial. So with that being said, can I please get survival checks from anyone who wants to help with navigating through the forest? And of course,
I'll try this again.
Oh God.
You said nature, right?
Survival.
Survival.
Would my navigator's tools help for this, or is that only for...
That would be for, like, water.
Ocean.
Fallon, guide us, please.
Okay. All right. Let me see here. So
I just keep directing Colleen which direction to walk or to travel.
Yep. Fallon seems pretty capable. Are you going at a normal pace? Are you continuing to push yourself? Like, eventually you run the risk of tiring yourself out, but, who knows how long you can push yourself for.
You're talking to the group.
Yeah, I'm talking to the group.
Because it's my favorite. Well, we're in the forest, right?
Right.
So that's that's my jam, right?
Yeah, it is. That's why I gave you advantage on this roll.
Right, but would I be exhausted like the others?
Oh, good call. No, you could probably keep going longer than them. But yeah, so basically the question is, are we normal pacing it? Are we pushing yourselves, in which case you might have trouble, you know, noticing dangerous things? You might get tired a little bit more easily, but you could get further during a day. Or are you trying to go like stealthy stealth and try to make things not notice you, but you'll go slower?
Did we make up for the time we lost already, or about that?
You get the feeling that you're about back on schedule.
Okay, the normal time with
me. I think we should take our time, make sure nothing sneaks upon us again. Keep our eyes peeled for any giant spiders. No more giant spiders.
You gonna develop a phobia?
I'm not scared of spiders.
I vote for, you know, going a bit faster, you know, because we gotta. What if we get slowed down up ahead? What if we meet? If we get lost or something?
Now we get now here.
While we're on the right track.
I don't think there was a time commitment, was there?
No.
Not for you.
I'm just establishing things because they matter.
Well, you know what? Maybe if I go at a normal pace, you'll spill the beans on why you need to go fast. like a normal pace.
Okay.
I'll go fast. I don't care. I'm not going to get exhausted. But if, you know, you all die and I'm the last one, it's going to be terrible.
I just don't want to go slow, really.
Okay, yeah. All right, that's fine. I'll, all right.
Super Sanic stalker.
So I have a general idea what's going on here. So I'll play this for a few minutes.
We spread out osmosis style because no one's going at the same pace.
Yeah, and you all individually die to, I don't know,
typhoid.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah, you get dysentery.
Why is there a terrace?
You get it's Oregon Trail.
You tried to cock the wagon, but you didn't make it across.
All right. So yeah. So you all sort of fall in behind Fallon. Pertland Wood, Fallon, by the way, is a bit different from the forest that you've spent most of your time in. Like, it's still pretty familiar terrain. But this is like a coniferous forest. There are lots of, like, fir and pine trees and things
damn
like that.
Damn, coniferous. Okay, so can I be on the lookout for the flowers I'm interested in?
Yes.
Just FYI.
Duly noted.
It's kind of a normal thing.
Duly noted. So yeah, and so you travel through the day. It's fairly pleasant. Fallon leads you pretty well. You feel like you made a pretty good time on day one. Please give me day two rolls as well.
For survival again?
Yep, same roll.
Not even gonna try. We got 22. We're good.
I don't try survival checks, not on the water.
All right.
I usually don't try, but I'm being helpful.
And day two, not only does Fallon, you know, pick the best path through the woods and just like laser focus, he also, the rest of you sort of start to fall in behind him and notice how he's, you know, moving so as to not like, I don't know, spend all his
trip
time
on through
tree branches and crap. Which would slow you down. Bushwhacking, if any of you have ever bushwhacked, it's a lot slower than walking down a path. And you guys are basically doing as good as walking down a path right now. So you make pretty good time on day two as well.
Raise Fallon.
All right. So on the morning of day three, you wake up and there's the wind has picked up significantly today. It's like whipping at you. It's sort of coming from the side. It's not going to like slow you down too much. But I mean, it's maybe like a 40 mile an hour wind. It's definitely noticeable. You'd have trouble like shooting an arrow at a distant target, for instance, or something like that. Mm-hmm. Definitely not necessarily pleasant. Go ahead and make one more round of survival checks.
Other people. Yeah. Come on.
We're lost, guys.
Get in there.
I'm helping.
I can't.
Get in there.
I'm just Fallon made good time yesterday. Let me see what I want to find today.
Nice.
We're helping.
It's not all of them. Come on. No one else can make one.
Someone help us.
So Fallon is... Oh, okay. So Fallon is obviously, like, irritated.
Once you guys recognize that you're lost, I'll try and help.
Is Hillel not going to roll?
I did.
Oh, he did.
Mine was six. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So Fallon got up on the wrong side of bed today.
Bad trip.
Let me see here. Let me see. This is going to be... Yeah, okay. But, you know, Alistair, Kane, you two sort of wind up towards the front with him, and between the three of you, you manage to pick a pretty decent path. So all this just being said...
Remind Fallon that the sun rises in the east.
Yep. As you walk through the forest, let me see here. Make... Okay. So, you know, you continue to pick your way through the trees, and eventually, though, everyone make perception checks. And actually... These are going to be a disadvantage due to the fierce...
Screw you! Screw you!
I wasn't looking at the screen. Honestly, I wasn't. Okay. Actually, though, Hillel, that's good enough. You're the only one who notices this. But
there's a dragon.
You notice that there are, you know, in addition to the trees, there are also like small shrubs and stuff along the side of the road. You also notice a vine hanging down from one of the trees. You're like, oh, that's kind of weird. And then you think for a moment, and you remember something that happened before. And... ta-da!
Oh!
Oh, yes.
All right, so...
what is this?
So are we supposed to be able to see the whole map?
Yup, because it's daytime.
Okay.
So, Hillel, you did notice this in time to alert your party and not be subject to...
Shut up. guys, look out!
So, let me think. So, it's a little bit after 9 o'clock right now. We have a few options. I don't mind, like, starting a combat and not finishing it tonight. And actually, I'm going to move you guys around based on...
Let's do it.
If I remember correctly, you guys are susceptible to
bleeding
fire,
the place.
So I'm on board for finishing tonight. It's time to protect the Alistair.
You would be by your rope, buddy. Okay. So we can start this combat and then just maybe not finish it if it gets too late and people want to leave. And... like, I have no problem keeping track of where we are in the middle of the combat, or we can call it here for tonight. Any strong opinions?
Let's start it.
All right.
Let them fight.
Everybody, as soon as I get this up, yeah, roll initiative.
Oh my god.
So let me see. Fallon, I'll go ahead and add you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Unless you want me to re-roll, you know.
No. Well, actually, though, you're in your favorite terrain, so I think you may have some sort of advantage here.
I'm cool with that.
Let me see here.
Let's just see if it's worth it.
Yeah, you
keep
have
continuing
on
look.
Initiative roll, so go ahead and roll initiative again, actually.
I did.
Oh, there are more of them.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, I didn't see the bottom ones.
That's a lot better.
Oh, God.
Okay.
These guys are pushovers, trust
I'm
me.
I'm excited.
Well, the small stick ones are. I don't know about the others.
So, 10.
Quick, Khalil, hide behind someone.
Thanks. Up behind you.
No.
It's gonna be at 6, and now I've got to add the bad guys.
Here's a trick, though, guys. Never defer your turn when you're first in order.
Defer's turn gets instant-get by spiders.
I mean, they happen to be... Like, I will let you know, I actually even rolled dice to determine where I put those spiders so that I wasn't, like, favoring anyone to be the first one attacked. So, just the two with the highest initiative wound up being right by you.
Yeah.
I think he just hates you, Stalker.
Okay.
I mean,
I got everybody.
But you put them in the same initiative group, so of course they'd both go together.
Yep. All right. So, first to act is Fallon, and let me remind myself here. Yeah, so you'll have advantage on anything you attack this turn.
Awesome. So I have. Do I know what these are?
Okay. So, let me see. Alistair and Halale know exactly what they are because they got attacked by some of these. Although you do notice that some of them look different. So these, like the one that I just moved, look like the little twigs that attacked you before.
Yeah.
These ones look beefier. This one. So,
like this game got more difficult or something.
Yeah, it's as if the enemies are becoming stronger.
I would rate this challenge higher than the last one.
So, Fallon, all that you would notice is that what seem to be animated plants are attacking you. These ones look like kind of little bundles of twigs. These ones, you see some like thorns and needles sprouting from them as well.
Okay. Shit, I thought I... Okay.
Running out of eraser.
So... So is it still windy? Is that still a thing? Or is
yeah,
that over
it's still
with?
A thing. So FYI, the way that works, it's a -2 penalty to ranged weapon attacks.
Oh, how nice. Like, on the damage or on the...
On the attack roll. So it's just a hit. If you hit, you do full damage. But
okay.
Although you do have advantage on your first attack, at least.
Okay, so I guess I'll yell to everybody, what the hell are these things? And then I'm going to use my crossbow on this one.
Okay. Go for it.
So.
Floop.
Okay.
I do love it.
You do, in fact, hit. So go and roll damage. Okay, yeah. You send your crossbow bolt going through it, and you see just like an explosion of twigs as the bolt goes, you know, crashing through it. That bolt will be recoverable, so don't deduct ammo. And blight down.
Lighthouse down.
All right. Would you like to do anything else?
If I move in the middle of everybody, will I still be able to shoot? Or is...
Yeah, like if there's...
I guess I can yell duck, right?
Yeah, you could probably... So like if they're right in front of you, you'll be able to go around them. Like I'll tell you if cover is going to impact something that you're trying to do. So like, you know, these trees, for instance, are here. Like if you tried to go against this one, it's like behind a tree and a log. That might have been a difficult shot, but...
Gotcha.
But you had a pretty clear line to this one.
Okay, I think I'll move right there.
Okay. That it?
Yep.
Alrighty then. So now we are to these guys. So they... Let me see if they can move 20 feet. That one can't actually get there. Right, so this one... Come charging up here.
It looks like this is 20 feet right here.
Yeah.
That's definitely where you should move.
I could move it here, though. That seems like a lot of fun. That seems like fun. So, so it's going to come here, and it's going to raise its twiggy arm and take a twiggy swing.
Shields up.
Yeah, I'm going to shield that.
Okay.
So it'll not attack me.
I think we have a shield. D20 roll incoming because of that.
Yep.
Okay. Yep. So this little bundle of twigs comes charging in. You think to yourself, well, I probably don't want to be hit by a stick. So you flash up your shield and you're all good.
Yep.
Alright, Colleen.
I'm going to make a chill touch on the red one next to me.
Will she land it?
That is the question.
Wait, which one are you attacking?
The one nearest me.
The one.
Dot. Oh, okay. Yep. Go for it. You are sick and tired of missing with this spell. You reach out, and the skeletal hand appears and, like, grabs around where you imagine the thing's neck would be if it had a neck. Go ahead and roll damage.
Plus six, huh?
Nailed it.
And some of its energy drains out of it.
It's in light, more like a chill, tap.
I mean, it was a 20, right? I mean,
I mean, he made very good contact. Just not.
It's still disadvantage.
You just kind of lobbed it in there. You didn't really.
The chill stroke.
Wait, are these things undead?
No.
Yeah, they're pretty alive to me.
So
it's disadvantaged. Oh, I wanted the one that was. I chose the wrong spell. Oh well. Continue.
Okay, I'm not sure what's going on, but that's fine.
Reading scales.
It's your turn, Kane.
For the win. Yeah, I'm gonna go help out this guy.
I attacked with the wrong spell.
Oh. It's unfortunate.
What is this team roll thing you speak of? I don't know. I'm gonna stab this thing in the face.
Go for it. Well, insofar as it has a face. Yep.
I'm just going to stab it.
Stab it in the twigs.
Stab twigs.
Yeah. Your rapier goes slashing through that bundle of twigs.
Stab, and then sneak attack stab because it's adjacent to that guy. I don't know whose token that is, but it's
first. That's Alistair.
Alistair.
Yeah.
You're rolling sneak attack?
Yeah, I was reading what he said.
Oh. Okay.
Boom.
Yup. So, you know, it's focused on Alistair and, like, what is this force in front of me? And you just come up, you swing your rapier straight through, and it just, the top half detaches from the bottom half, falls over, and then both simultaneously just crumple into what appear to be normal twigs. And twig blight down. All right. And we are now to the fancy guy's turns. So let me see here.
Does that include me later on? Right?
We will find out.
Oh, I also yell to
screw you.
Don't die this time.
Wait.
Okay, so I'll do that.
Hillel can preemptively yell, avenge me.
All right, so we're going to have one each going at Kane, Alistair, and Johan. So,
look at that, there's two.
So you see the fancy-looking ones? They sort of open up a little bit on top, and you see a bunch of thorns sort of all poised to go, and they fire out a shower of needles.
Oh, joy.
So here is the one against Kane. Here is the one against Alistair.
Kane, hit me.
And here is the one against Johan. Okay.
Is your shield still up?
Shield does stay till the next turn, but I'm pretty sure that makes my AC 18. Because I didn't get one of those magical Cloak of Resistances.
It's okay. I owe a debt of 250 gold.
Alright, so, Alistair, the thorns penetrate your shield.
Oh,
plaster themselves across your chest. You take that
good
many
thing
damages.
I'm a beefy sorcerer. Oof.
Rip, buddy.
That's a few damages.
I got some tweezers.
All right, and let me see. After they fire, let me see how far I can just move.
Dream is dead.
This
Who's
to
18?
Shift over here. That one will stay where it is, and this one will just...
Wait, are they not affected by the wind? Cheetahs.
Oh,
not get hit by the second one?
No, you're right. They would be affected by the wind. Alistair, give yourself your HP back.
Haha! Team never been hit.
Yeah, no.
Same team.
Stalker, thank you for correcting me. There is a heavy wind blowing, and a bunch of the needles get blown away, and your shield handles the rest.
Yes. Rules.
Yeah, we were wondering who the other 18 was attacking.
The other 18 was attacking Johan, who has really high AC with the shield.
Nice. Go, Johan.
All right. So we are now to these other ones. So this one... I'll try to get a bite of flail.
Bite me.
And this one...
Come at me. Do your worst.
This one...
Well, that's closer. That's closer.
Yeah, you know what? We're going for it.
Taunting wasn't the best idea. Let's go.
Prepare yourself.
Plus no crits again.
All right, so Halael, two twig blights come charging towards you. You're like, these things don't hit me. The first one comes in and lunges low. The second one lunges high. You jump. You do a little handstand. You pop back over. You're ready to roll. It is your turn.
All right, let's just get some punches out. I'm going to punch the one directly in front of me right now to start with.
Okay. Yep, punch away. Yeah, so the Fist of Fury goes into the twigs. The twigs explode and shower down. Twig light down.
And then I'm going to use my bonus action to do my other attack. Because...
And you know what? You've been flipping like mad. You've been dancing like the wind. You're like, yes, this isn't going to be like last fight. And then you completely whiff on your second attack. But you do balance, recover yourself. You're poised and in position. Would you like to do anything else?
I'm good. I'm just going to stand proud.
Okay.
You're still standing.
All right, Alistair.
Yep. And I know that it's windy, but I'm going to try to trade blows with this one and cast Firebolt.
Okay, I'm trying to think. That's not actually a weapon attack, so you're good.
Perfect.
There's actually no minus two.
I'm going to use the advantage anyway because Tides of Chaos. Let's do it. Where did that go?
Yep. Go ahead and roll damage. All right, so you send a firebolt screeching. Oh, actually, wait a minute. Let me think about this. Yeah, that thing should have cover, but even with the cover, you're going to hit it. So the firebolt goes screeching between the trees, over the log, smashes into the blight. It catches, it sort of thrashes around for a little while, and then settles down into a charred hump of sticks.
Easy, boys. I like the trees better than the zombies. No, that's all for my turn.
Alright. It is now Johan's turn. And go for this guy, I guess. And Warhammer attack. And that actually is a hit. So yeah, you see Johan go charging forward. His hammer smashes down into the, it's a needle blight. And it appears hurt, but still animate. Fallon.
I'm going to use my crossbow floomp to attack. I don't know why it's not doing it. Okay.
Okay, you will have minus two on this because of the wind.
Do I still get the advantage?
No, because that's only
on the first attack.
Haven't acted yet, basically. So once the creature's acted, you don't get the bonus anymore.
Yeah, let's do it anyway.
Okay. I mean, you are skilled in archery, so. All right. So yeah, you send your crossbow bolt screeching across the clearing, smashes into the blight. And a chunk of it goes flying away, and it, insofar as a pile of plant matter can look pissed, it looks pissed.
Cool. And Okay. I guess nobody... I yelled earlier, what are these? And no one wanted to say anything.
Tree monsters.
Bunch of sticks. They're vulnerable to fire.
Yeah.
I don't have fire. Oh, dang it. I guess I can't go back and add the ensnaring strike to that.
I'll allow it. This once.
Okay, do I need to roll anything for that?
Generous no, GN. It needs to make a strength check.
Be weak. Be weak.
Hey!
It is weak. So
nice.
So yeah, so you see... I forget the flavor on this. Is it vines?
It's a bunch of vines attacking
yeah.
a bunch of vines.
Yeah, so a bunch of vines sprout out from around the bolt as it crashes in and hold it to the ground. Go ahead and roll a d6 for the damage. The blight feels betrayed by its own kind. All right. But it continues to struggle. All right. Anything else?
Plant on plant violence.
Yeah, go ahead and make sure you marked yourself down a spell slot for doing that.
Okay. How do I indicate that? Oh, it's just
you,
this.
Here, I'll go ahead and just show it to you.
I think I did it. Tell me if I didn't.
Okay, I will. So actually, I'm on your character sheet right now. You just do this. So this is, so this left one that I just changed right here. That's like how many slots you have, and then this right one is how many you've used.
So, oh, okay. So I just changed.
The left one is two, and the right one is one. So you have two
okay.
slots you've used more.
All right. Yeah, I moved the left one down. That's what I did. Okay.
I mean, like honestly, if you want to track it that way in the future, that's kind of fine. Except you might forget how many spell slots you have.
So, yeah. No, we're good.
All right. Anything else?
I'm good, man. All right. Solid.
The twig blight that remains is going to continue. It's fierce charge and attack clean.
Two of them still remain.
No!
Oh, snap. Mighty Blight.
I'm going to use Absorb Elements towards the piercing damage.
I don't think that works.
It just says designate a type of damage on a melee attack.
One reaction we take acid, cold, fire, lightning, or thunder.
Oh, I see. Okay. Well, it'll go that through sucks. If I use a shield, so. Guess I'm joining the taking damage club.
No.
Okay. All right.
Hit by a stick.
Yep. You feel a sharp stick impact your midsection, and it hurts. How much does it hurt, you ask? It hurts 3 damage worth.
Damn it.
These guys are strong.
It was a good dream.
Wait, so who's still in the no damage club? Just Alistair?
No, just Alistair.
All right. Okay, Colleen, it's your turn.
I'm going to Booming Blade it.
All right.
I really, really hard. I'm so good at this.
You use your Booming Blade, and you are incensed at having been hit by sticks. And you miss.
No offhand attack.
And with the second one, you can you remember you can do things. Go ahead and roll damage.
Okay. Dagger. Piece of garbage. Good job, dagger.
Okay. Yeah. Yep.
The booming blade doesn't work, though, right? Because it's technically on the main hand
right.
dagger.
It is.
Right.
But with your offhand, you just, like, in an act of almost disgust, you just... Is Colleen right or left-handed?
Right-handed.
Okay. You swipe the dagger in front of you, and either the twig blight was weaker than you thought, or you're stronger than you thought, because twig blight down.
It still hurt me, and I'm sad.
All right. Kane.
I'm going to... How far away am I from this one? That's too far. No, I can go there. I'm going to go there, next to Rope Buddy.
So, in order to not go through this twig blight space, you'll have to do that, and then... Yep, that works.
All right. And then... Oh, hold on, I switch things. Now I'm going to stab it.
All right. Yep, stab away. Okay. Let me see here. And yeah, you'll have sneak attack as well. Yep. So
I got you, Rope Buddy.
Yep, you slip in beside Rope Buddy. You bring your rapier up and around, and twigs and needles go flying everywhere. All right, and now it is this one's turn. Oh, wait, and this one's restrained. So let me see. But it's just actually going to continue to try to fire away. So it sees Colleen. It'll go after Colleen, but it is at disadvantage and suffering minus two. So we'll see how this goes. Okay. Yeah. So the blight readies a bunch of needles and fires them away. And, you know, just as it fires them, it was kind of a weak attempt. And a big gust of wind comes in and just sweeps them all away.
Okay, I'm okay with this.
Now it's this guy's turn. We'll go after Halil. Think that'll hit. Stalker?
Oh, sorry.
That's all right.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. Maybe.
So you also feel the branch of death as it swipes across your thigh. And you hurt that much.
Inner caress of the thigh. Caress of the inner thigh. That's it. All
right.
All right. Well, I don't like strange creatures touching my thighs.
You take two shame damage.
So it's time to do something like a roundhouse kick and take this thing down.
All right. Yep, kick away. Yeah, and boom, plink, 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 plink. Blight down.
And I guess there's still that one all the way over there.
There is that one all the way over there.
Oh,
easy.
I lost my spaceship over it.
Yeah, guys, monks get bonus movement. And you have advantage because it's currently restrained by...
Yeah, but I don't have any moves left, do I?
Oh, did it take additional damage at the beginning of its turn?
Oh, is that what it says?
It says 1d6 at start of each of its turns.
Oh, yep. Go ahead and roll 1d6.
I'm just going to run over to a dead corpse.
Well, I won't require you to run if he winds up killing it. And actually, yeah, he did wind up killing it. So if you don't want to run all the way over there, you don't have to.
Yeah, I'll go make sure it's a pile of sticks.
Okay.
Pile of sticks.
So you go over and you look down and the vines have just like crunched all the way through it. And it sits in four pieces on the ground.
I might retrieve his crossbow bolts for him.
Okay. You retrieve a crossbow bolt for Fallon. Because I think that's all that went on to it.
Heck of a deal.
Alright. You have fended off the Blight Attack Redux. And, oh wow, that actually worked out almost perfectly. So, okay, yeah, I'll open up to the floor if anyone wants to say anything after that, but you're now just back to walking through the woods.
Ooh.
We're a lot more capable during the day, it turns out.
Still very sad.
I feel like Kylene's at least intrigued by plant monsters.
I'm also intrigued by pain that I have never felt.
I thought one of them had almost gotten me, but I don't know what happened. Just got really lucky.
Got hit with a switch, man.
Alright, so you continue to plow on through the day. Eventually the sun is very much setting. You look around, make camp once again, and I'm not tipping my hand here at all, but please make survival checks, anyone who wants to help find your place of rest for the night.
I want to survive.
Yeah, you do.
Jeez. Do I get advantage on survival in the woods?
You do, but...
Don't need it, yeah.
In this case, it was actually Fowlin. As you wander through the woods, you remember what happened last time. The GM told you to make a survival check to figure out where you were sleeping for the night. No, Haleel wouldn't know that. But you look and you see... You remember that first place where Fowlin had you settle for the night? You know, just sort of a nice little sheltered rock area away from...
The first place we didn't get attacked.
Anything too nasty seeming. And you look over and you see a similar location. And you point there. And that is where you make camp for the night.
Oh, no.
And... If anyone has anything you want to do, please do so. But otherwise, that is where we will end it.
All right. Stream.
Will we heal up that night? Or if the night happened and we might get attacked and killed?
Do not restore your hit points or spells.
Okay.
All right.
Sure.
Yep. So, thanks to... Wow, apparently multiple people who watched. So. And stopping stream.